Hello and welcome to this tutorial. In this video, we'll present how you can convert survey measurements handed to you in a text format into useful elevation information and create a terrain model in your AutoCAD drawing. In order to begin, let's check this drawing, which is a typical case of this situation. We have been given a georeference drawing containing various points with an elevation label. However, if we take a closer look, we will see that this is not exactly the case. Let's select one of these points, right-click it, and view its properties. As we can see, we have to deal with a plain text object that has no elevation info in the z-axis. At this point, the only elevation info we have is the text value of this object. To acquire access to the elevation information in a form that can be used for terrain creation, our first step will be to extract this information using AutoCAD's command data extraction. This command will open the data extraction wizard, which allows us to extract object data from drawings in tables or external files. On the first window of this wizard, we are prompted to choose if we will work with a new or an existing data extraction. To do that, we select New, click Next, and then select the file name and destination of our preference. Then, we are prompted to the second wizard window. Here, we are going to select the source of our extracted data. We choose to select objects from the current drawing, specify all the text objects which contain the elevation data in the drawing, and then we proceed. In the next wizard window, we are asked to define which objects we want to extract data from. Since we have only selected text objects, only one category appears, so we click Next to move on to the next window. Here, we are going to define which exact properties we want to extract from our text objects. We unselect the categories 3D Visualization, Drawing, and General, as only the categories Geometry and Text include information that interests us. From the remaining properties, we select only the position X, position Y, and value. This way, we will extract the information of each text object in the X, Y, and Z axes, which will be used in terrain creation. In the next wizard window, we unselect the Show Count column and the Show Name column, so we can only extract the information needed and click Next. Then, we will output data in an external file. As file type, we will leave it as XLS format, then select Next and Finish. Now that we have completed the data extraction, we are going to adjust our data to convert them in a form where they can be used in Plex-Earth 5D for terrain creation. To do so, we open the XLS file. We create it with Google Sheets. Of course, you may open the file with Microsoft Office Excel if you prefer. We want to create a column containing the X, Y, Z data into one column separated by a comma. For this purpose, we are using the equation displayed on your screen for the first row of our data and then apply that to all the rows of our file. Now, we only want the data in the column we created to be contained in our file. We copy the D column and paste it to an empty one as plain values. Then we delete the first row and all the other columns except our newly created one. We want to end up with only having our data in the first column separated by commas. The next step is to extract our data in a file format which can be used in Plex-Earth 5D. For this purpose, we select File, then Download, and as preferred file type, we choose Tab Separated Values. If you're using Microsoft Office Excel, you can export your data as a text file. Our file should end up looking like this. Now, we're going to implement our final step to create a terrain model, using our extracted elevations. For this purpose, we're going to use the Create Surface from File command of Plex-Earth 5D. We select the respective command in our Plex-Earth 5D ribbon, and then select to load the tab-separated values file we just created. Now we have to define which column of our files corresponds to which axis. We type 1 for the X column, 2 for the Y column, 3 for the Z column, and we specify the delimiter as the comma. Since we do not have a boundary, we just press Enter. And here you go. The terrain creation has been completed. We have created a terrain model into our AutoCAD environment using Plex-Earth 5D. We can also turn the visual style to conceptual for better visualization of our model. Notice that the created terrain model appears as a surface through our terrain manager, giving us the ability to benefit from all the related Plex-Earth 5D commands. You can try the above process without any further ado by starting a free trial of Plex-Earth 5D through this link. Hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.